Got everything, I got everything. I cannot complain, I cannot. I don't even know how much I really made. I forgot, it's a lot. Never mind what I got. Don't watch that, cause I came up, that's all me. Stay true, that's all me. No help, that's all me.
Mustapha Heron, West Haven, Connecticut, sophomore high school. Go to Wolverhampton Academy, Wolverhampton, Massachusetts. What's up, y'all? This your boy, G the General. I'm here with my man, Mustapha Heron, of West Haven, Connecticut. He's a 6'6 point guard in the class of 2016. Some people, even ESPN, rank him in the top 15. We're going to have a little nice little conversation with my man to see where he is and what he got going on in the future. All right, so hope you guys enjoy it, and we'll be back in a few seconds. What's up, y'all? We back. We're here with my man, Mustapha Heron. Mustapha, you know, I'm just a little curious, you know, since I knew you, you know, just a little bit. The people want to know what made you start playing, and at what age did you think you started playing?
Started playing around 2 or 3 years old. My dad introduced me to the game at a young age. Always had fun playing, and I always found that, you know, it was just like home. The court was always like home, so that's where it started.
Okay, that's what's up. So you say your dad introduced you to the game. Did your dad play basketball? Was your dad a farmer?
Oh, yeah.
Or what did your dad do?
He played overseas. He played Division I basketball. That's an experience playing the game.
Oh, okay. You say he played Division I basketball. What school did he go play for?
Central Connecticut State University.
Central Connecticut State University. Where is that at? Is that in Connecticut?
Yeah.
The U is, as he would call it, the U. Mr. Brian Heron of Connecticut. He was in the Hall of Fame, you know, for those of you who don't know, for the Central Connecticut. But, you know, that's what's up. So what do you think, what are your motivations and your goals, you know, that you have set for yourself going forward?
My motivation is always to get better, always try to be the best player I can be. Goals is try to get to the highest level I can possibly get to.
Mm, which could be what?
Hopefully the NBA.
True.
Take it step by step.
True. So what type of workouts or what's your regimen for as far as you working out and stuff like that? How much do you work out a week or a day?
Work out 2 times a day, pretty much every day of the week. So all in all, get about 4 or 5 hours a day. And that's just basketball, weight training, helping my body recover. So it's all based around basketball.
Who do you work out with, or who does what?
My dad, my coach, and then something recovery wise, I just do it by myself. A lot of ice, a lot of stretching.
So what do you think you need to work on to get to the next level, whether it's college or pros and stuff like that?
Just becoming a better all-around player, never letting my game taper off, just trying to get good at as many things as possible.
This is why I do this shit. I think they call this venting. This is me, still the same. They want the hits, I play the game. No auto-tune, but you can feel the pain. It all comes spilling out like I hit a vein. What up, Lil Bruh? What up, Slumville? I hope you know that y'all the reason I have fun still. And fans thinking that we all sign for 1 mil. Equal opportunity rapping, that shit is unreal. That ain't how it works, that ain't how it goes. And I be getting high just to balance out the lows. And I could use a writer just to balance out my flows. But I never share my thoughts, this is all in the nose. And every time I try, it opens up my eyes.
Okay. Mustapha, being I've been following you as well as since you've been 6, 7 years old, I know you're a good kid and you're kind of humble, but how is this whole superstar status, how have you handled that with being recruited and now walking in the gym and kids going, psh, 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 that's that kid Mustapha, you know, because I know even in my gym, I had a couple of kids sneak some pictures saying, there you go right there, that's Mustapha's in the gym. How do you handle that and who's helped prepare you for stuff like that?
I just try to go out and work as hard as I can because I always know that there's somebody behind me that wants my spot. So I just try to protect it and then try to just keep climbing up the ladder. My dad's helped me prepare for that a lot, just always talking me through things, you know, just stuff like that. Mm-hmm.
So So how do you handle just the kid part though? Like, do people start asking you for pictures and stuff like that?
It's fun. I mean, because I always see people like on TV. I watch LeBron James after the game. Like, people want to take pictures. People want his autograph, and that's somewhere like that's the level I want to play on. Eventually, one day, hopefully, I can play on that level. But it's just fun right now, being at this young age, being able to have that opportunity to just see people smile just because they're looking at me. Never imagined people would smile just from seeing me.
So I hear you say about LeBron. I heard that you had an opportunity to be in the same gym with LeBron, Carmelo, Chris Paul. How did that whole thing come about?
I was at a 5-star basketball camp. It was a great experience. I mean, LeBron's my favorite player, so just being like in his presence, I mean, he was great. I mean, he was just like, he was happy. He was, you know, he was fun to be around. He made jokes with us. He was kind of like he was like a kid. You know, he wasn't cocky or anything like that. I mean, Chris Paul's great. Dwayne Wade, Carmelo, they're all just good guys. I mean, they have fun, and you can tell they love basketball. And they just love it.
So, if you had to take anything from that experience, what was the best thing that you got out of that whole piece right there? The whole piece being in the gym with those guys. That was a tough one. That was an Oprah question.
That was a hop hole. Flip Oprah around.
What was the question again?
Being that you had that experience, what was some of the things that what was one thing that you would take from that whole thing, from those guys? Being that you had that opportunity to be in the gym with LeBron, Melo, Chris Paul, and all those guys, what are one of the things that you could take from those guys to help you going forward, whether it's dealing with kids or stuff like that?
Oh, yeah, very, very humble guys. I mean, just respectable guys. You know, they just have fun. I mean, not cocky or anything like I said before.
Yeah. They didn't like shush you and get out of here type of stuff.
If somebody wanted an autograph, they gave them an autograph, pictures, all that stuff, and they do it happily because they like seeing the smiles on kids' faces.
So how did you get the opportunity to play against Chris Paul? How did that whole opportunity come up?
In the middle of a water break, they were shooting around at half court and they were betting money on it, and Chris Paul actually took the ball from one of the kids and he gave it to me and asked me if I could dunk. So I went up and dunked it, and I grabbed it off the rim and I passed it back to him, and he asked if I could play defense too. So he started dribbling a little bit, and everybody in the camp just kind of gathered around, and the rest was history.
Who went next?
Again with my man Mustapha Heron. Mustapha, you know, I've been playing around, juggling around these names, man, trying to come up with my own name, because I'm not really good at remembering kids' names or people's names. So when people ask me about you and stuff like that, you know, I kind of came up with this name. I don't know how you like it, you know, whether you like it or not, I'm going to call you it until you create your own. But I'm kind of stuck with this Lion King thing. What do you feel about the Lion King? You know,
it's fitting. Because my name actually means king, so it's fitting. I like it.
But do you think that you can handle the boulder that comes with that on your shoulder?
Yes.
With being able to come in and, you know, meaning that you're going to have to run every gym, you know, be able to control all the games and stuff like that. Do you think you're ready for that?
Yes.
Because I'm sure you've been already challenged by some of the better players and teams and stuff like that already.
Yeah.
Okay. So how has your family handled that? Do you think your family is ready for you to be called or to give you a name, Pookie, Moo Moo, something like that? Is there any name that mom is saying, no, I want you to still be Moo Moo, you know?
Mustapha.
Okay. Well, we're going to be working on that as well for Mr. Lion King. We're going to work on some names. But like I said, the most important thing that we hope that you do is continue to get better, continue to work on your academics, and just continue to be a positive role model for the kids and in the community and stuff like that. Because I can't remember the last person that out of Connecticut that represented Connecticut through the USA basketball and stuff like that, besides from a good friend of mine, Nadine DeMone. I congratulate you on all your accomplishments, and hopefully you continue to go on and do great things. And just don't forget about the people here in UConn Nation. What's up, Kevin Ollie? Pushing it. Don't forget about me. Final Four tickets, you know, whatever. All right, we're here once again. The General's Report, my man Mustapha Heron. Thanks for coming. Appreciate it. All right, peace.
Yo, fam.
What's up?
Yo, fam.
Formulating up plots to escape from Salem's lot, cause it's scorching hot, making it hard trying to figure who's out to trap me. But tacky, got all kinds of undercover.